Hello, welcome, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Juggernaut, and today I figure it's time for a bit of a chat. See, it's been a bit of a while since I've done a channel update, and, well, first of all, Happy New Year, Merry Christmas, Bestus Festivus for the rest of us, and so on and so forth. Happy holidays, everyone, and I hope this year treats you much better than the previous one, both in terms of the, you know, general global happenings of everything that's going on in the world, and you personally, of course. As far as I'm concerned, previous year was alright, wasn't bad by any means. However, I'm looking forward to this one. And I have some big news, both for the channel and for me personally, and so on and so forth. So let me start off with this. I've noticed that recently, or I've noticed, I accept that recently, over the past few months or so, I haven't been the most consistent in terms of my uploads. And there's been multiple reasons for that. One is, ever since I've upgraded my PC, I've been struggling with OBS, and I wanted to move on to a different kind of recording software, but there's not much else out there other than Bandicam, which is a bit, well, I'll be honest with you, it's a bit expensive. So yeah, I wanted to get this to work, and I've got it to work fine with Project Zomboid and what was the other one, with Bioshock, but I couldn't get it to record Cyberpunk very well. And then there was another game I tried to record, it was Mass Effect, yeah, and it wouldn't record very well at all, in that it would crash, not OBS, it would crash my whole PC. Which I'm sure you would agree is a pretty big problem when you're trying to record something. Now, obviously, the issue there being, if the game crashes, I lose all the recording, and, well, suffice it to say, I had to do one particular mission in Mass Effect like 7 times because of the crashes. Every time I think I fix it, it crashes again. So yeah, that's why the series sort of took a bit of a break, and I wanted to do some other things until I got that sorted, and then there was a bit of a problem at work, and there was some chaos there, and I was kept very busy, and etc, etc, and yeah, excuses, excuses. Now, however, let's talk about the most important thing that you're here for, the channel, the series, the video games, the Let's Plays, and so on and so forth. For this year, I will still occasionally, of course, do first impressions, first look at, etc, etc, whatever you want to call it, the different video games, that's staying, but I do want to focus the channel on Let's Plays a little bit more. And specifically, I want to get more videos out, and I want to get videos out consistently. And I think, given... Okay. Sorry about that. Turns out I still haven't quite fixed OBS to the point where it's willing to record... what was it? Cyberpunk. Yeah, I'll get on that these days, I suppose. But let me finish my sentence and then we'll move to a different game, I suppose, because this one just really doesn't want to be recorded. I want to get out videos more consistently. I want to get out videos more or less every day. And that's something that I will try and do for pretty much the remainder of the year. Currently, in the sort of short term, I will continue Project Zomboid regularly. It won't be a super long series. Obviously, this is the kind of thing that can go on for, you know, 1,000 episodes, but no. I'm going to keep it for maybe like a couple of more weeks at the most. And then once I'm done with Project Zomboid, I will move on to something else. Let's say, for example, well, we'll talk about that in a little bit. But yeah, I'll move on to something else once I'm done with that. And Bioshock, obviously, I will play the game to the end. And those are the two main series, and I will, in the meantime, sort of in between those two, I will finish Mass Effect as well. So yeah, just to put that out there, the series will come to its conclusion, at least Mass Effect 2. I don't know when I'm going to go back and play Mass Effect 3 as well. I'm probably going to take a bit of time off, and then afterwards I will move on to something else, but I will talk about the future videos and the future games that I will play in a little bit. For now, let me find something else to record and to play, and we can go on with the update. But the biggest news and the most important thing is that I will try and put out a video every single day, or at least most of the time every single day. It gets a bit problematic around the weekend since I'm not actually here and, you know, work, etc, etc. But yeah, I'll try and do that for that. That's sort of my New Year's resolution, right? Speaking of New Year's, this video was supposed to come out on the 1st, but it had some issues and before that, and well, I wanted to take a few days off to just spend with my family and girlfriend and, you know, relax for a little bit before I get back into, you know, the actual swing of things and start working again, and part of that, you know, start recording again and, you know, doing this too, along with regular work. So, anyways, let's find something to play and continue the video in but a moment. Okay, so if you can't find anything else, then stick with the 2011 classic, right? Yeah, look, I'm sorry, but I have nothing on my hard drive currently that's remotely interesting in terms of recording that I'm not Let's Playing already, so yeah, sorry. Yeah, we're going to have to stick with this. Anyways, as I was saying, the plan is consistency and to, you know, do have more of it, basically, but other than that, I do want to talk about one more thing today, and that is, generally speaking, the future of the channel and the series and the kind of videos that I want to do. And here I suspect that from a monetary standpoint and from a standpoint of, you know, how do I put this, channel growth, not so much money that the channel brings in, it doesn't bring in much, it's just like a couple of bucks to play, help pay the bills. I'm not talking about this as a business, I'm talking about channel growth and viewership and stuff like that. I'm probably going to shoot myself in the foot a little bit here, but ah, to hell with it. I don't like most of the new games, right? That's kind of a big deal for me. I really don't like most of the new games. I loved Baldur's Gate. I think Elden Ring was pretty cool. Not really my thing, but it was pretty good. I kind of preferred the original Dark Souls, to be honest with you, than Elden Ring. The open world nature for me for a Dark Souls game is a bit... Never mind, though, just personal taste. Game's great. Baldur's Gate, to me, was just almost perfect. And I think I mentioned it this morning when I was recording a video about the Game Awards, which should come out, I think, after this. Anyways, yeah, so it's phenomenal. But it's kind of the exception to the rule. I've noticed that most games that come out nowadays, be they strategy games, RPGs, whatever, I'm not just the greatest fan of, right? Not really my thing. And to that extent, I don't think I'm going to be playing a great many of them for the channel going forward. So what I want to do is, instead, I want to Let's Play games for this channel that I truly enjoy, because that's when I think I make my best videos. That's when I think the quality of the content that I produce is at its highest. Now, I'm talking like I'm making some sort of high-budget movie here. Not really, but still, at the same time, I think my commentary, my editing is at its best when I'm doing it for a video in which I'm playing a video game, which I genuinely like. I'm genuinely having fun. And I know exactly when videos become a drag to make, and when I'm playing it just for the YouTube audience rather than just for me. Right? And so, to that end, for this year, I've decided that I kind of want to go back. I kind of want to go back in time, and I want to play games that I really enjoyed playing, and that I will enjoy making YouTube Let's Plays of, rather than focusing just on, you know, what's the new thing, what's popular, etc., etc. And it's not like I was chasing popularity, clout, and the greatest, latest hip thing with this channel at any point whatsoever, but it was kind of in the back of my mind, right? Things like, why on earth would I play, let's say, for example, Dragon Age 1 in 2023, when there's probably going to be some new hot RPG out there for me to try, or something along those lines. Maybe not even RPG, but just like a newer game for me to try. And to be honest with you, I'm just not having fun with most of the stuff that comes out nowadays. I don't like the state of the gaming industry. I don't like the quality and philosophy behind the making of most AAA video games, and if I'm honest, with a lot of video games in general. I don't like the economical state of the industry, and I don't like the creative mindset of it either. Exceptions, like I said, Baldur's Gate is there, but it's the exception to the general rule. So instead, for this Steam, winter sale, I picked up The Witcher 3. The Witcher 2 and The Witcher 1. And I really want to play through the entire trilogy. Now, Juggernaut, playing through The Witcher 1 in 2023 until recently is when I picked it up, but 2024 now, is kind of career suicide, don't you think? I mean, it's an old game, nobody wants to watch that, right? Well, on the one hand, yes. On the other hand, when there's nobody doing it, it sort of automatically creates a little bit of a market around the thing. But here's the thing. I promise you that a full playthrough of The Witcher 1, with all its imperfections, is going to be infinitely better from a viewing perspective, from the audience's perspective, than me playing a game I'm not having fun with. And I'll give you an example of that as well, Starfield. Starfield, I just didn't like. The fact that the game, at one point, bugged out so much to stop me from actually progressing within the game itself, and I had to, you know, start from all over again, didn't help my experience, not going to lie, but generally speaking, I don't like its design philosophy, I don't like its gameplay, I don't like the game. It's a bit boring, I'm sorry. I know there's like a small cult following around it that exists, I've seen the Reddit subreddits and posts and stuff like that, which I've also mentioned this morning, oddly enough. But anyways, just it's not the game for me. The latest Call of Duty campaigns and stuff like that, which I've never done on this channel, not my thing, but it will be infinitely better than any of those. From a viewing perspective as well, I mean, for me playing, obviously, but from an entertainment perspective of you, the viewer, I can promise you that I will bring you the best possible videos that I can make. And the only way to do that, for me, unfortunately or fortunately, is to genuinely enjoy what I'm doing. I can put on a fake face and pretend I like the game and pretend to stay immersed and like it and keep going, but I can only pretend so far. And it becomes a drag and it gets to the point where I don't want to sit down and record. I don't want to. I want to do it for the YouTube views and for you guys and I want to, you know, entertain you people, but I don't want to do it because I'm not having fun with it. The best series that I've ever made. I believe, in terms of the quality of the videos, in terms of how fun they are to both watch and record, were in games that I genuinely enjoyed myself the most. Metro, Stellaris, Stalker, obviously, Anomaly, games like that, right? Mass Effect, too. And so, to that end, going forward from this year, I no longer want to think about when this game came out. I want to think about whether I'm having fun with this game or not. And it is kind of like shooting myself in the foot a little bit. Don't get me wrong. Now, playing through Baldur's Gate would be kind of interesting, and, you know, it's a game I genuinely enjoy, and it would be great, but the problem is everyone has sort of had the same idea, where they're going, well, yeah, you know, I'd love to play through Baldur's Gate, and then there's a billion playthroughs of it, and the average enjoyer of Let's Plays, let's say, will take one look at his subscription fee and realize that there's seven different people let's playing Baldur's Gate, and it's a bit of a problem. You're not going to watch all seven of them. Nobody would, right? Of course. But you do have, obviously, the option of playing through something like that much, much later when everyone is... I put this one when everyone's done with the game. Yeah, that exists as an option. I think Gopher's doing that right now. Those of you that don't know, huge inspiration for the channel and his general style of let's playing and video making as a whole. Absolutely love the guy. And that's fair enough. I see that as an option. But for me, I think the best possible thing from a quality perspective for the channel I can do is focus on games that I want to play. And currently, for this year, and I genuinely have plans for the entire year. Now, at the same time, don't get me wrong, I am fully aware of the saying, best laid plans of mice and men, right? And the local dialect would be somewhat more vulgar and direct. I think locally here we say, make all the plans you want, but the man upstairs is laughing his ass off. Yeah, it's, like I said, a bit more vulgar, but you get the point, gets the point across, that, you know, I can make plans for the entire year and then, you know, my PC explodes or something, God forbid, right, knock on wood. You never know what's going to happen is kind of the point, and it's not really, you know, you're not really meant to never make plans, but at the same time, it's kind of like saying, you know, plans will only get you so far. It's improvisation and sort of going with it is a lot more important. Anywho, with that, I guess, segment of life philosophy out of the way, I wanted to sort of lay out those plans publicly here and sort of commit to them and stick to them. I want to play through the Witcher series, 1, 2, and 3, this year. I've also been looking at other RPGs that I've enjoyed, stuff like Dragon Age, something that, you know, to basically, after I'm done with Mass Effect, to go through all of that. Stuff like Dragon Age might be an option. I loved all three of the Dragon Age games. Though I'm not sure how well they hold up now, that's one thing. I have a relatively good memory of Dragon Age 1. Dragon Age 2 I'm not so sure about, so we'll see. But games like that. Obviously I will come back to Stalker as well, the newest Escape from Pripyat rendition, if you will, or the newest version of it. Although a part of me, given, you know, the fact that I'm now sort of planning out how the channel is going to go for a longer time, a good part of me wants to kind of wait a little bit longer. Specifically, I want to wait for the next update of Anomaly, the one that's going to have all the weapon customizations and improvements and stuff like that, and I want to play through that instead. I'm going back right now because it's kind of too similar to what I previously played, although I'll see, it depends on how things go, for me personally, I guess, how I'm feeling and etc, etc, but the idea is, I want to play through The Witcher, it's going to take a long while, and I'm going to play through probably another RPG series, like Dragon Age, like, I don't know, maybe Baldur's Gate, maybe something like that. I want to play through a game like that as well, and just enjoy myself. At the same time, I do understand that I attract a rather diverse crowd of enjoyers of different genres, and that whilst RPGs are probably the most fun for me to record and where I shine the most, if that makes sense, because it's the type of game where you have the character that you're playing as, you have the story, but yourself as the recording person, right, yourself as the player, also get to shine a little bit with your decisions, with your commentary, with your insight on what's happening, etc, etc. It's kind of why I like RPGs a lot. You get to play the character, but you also get to play yourself a little bit as a role, as, you know, the YouTuber recording it. Anyways, stuff like Fallout New Vegas, which I don't think I've ever played. I don't know if I've played for the channel as a proper Let's Play. That would be grand as well. And all of these games I've picked up, some of them I've installed, like Skyrim I've been playing a little bit off of the new Nolvus mod pack. And I've been looking at these games, I've, you know, at various points that I've picked up, some recently in the winter sale, some a long, long time ago. I've been looking at them in my Steam list, and I'm thinking, this is where I had the most amount of fun. And a part of me feels like I'm in that sort of age where I really will hate myself if I start chasing after the latest thing and the clout and stuff like that, because I'm just not enjoying myself. Tell you what, some of the most enjoyable moments of the last week or so for me have been in gaming in general. They've been right here at this pier, fishing in Minecraft. Well, and building all of these things in a hardcore world. And that's been phenomenally fun for me. And I know Minecraft doesn't go over well on my channel. I've experimented with that in the past, let's say. But it's been like some of the most fun I've had in video games, period. And I've loved it. And, you know, also, for example, in Skyrim, same thing, loads of fun. Played some New Vegas, like a couple of hours of it. I didn't actually commit to a playthrough or anything, just wanted to test out how some of the mods are working and etc, etc. Played through New Vegas, loved it. Baldur's Gate, I'm actually playing co-op right now with someone, and we're having so much fun with it. It was just amazing, right? Local co-op, by the way. Speaking of, do you know how to start local co-op in Baldur's Gate 3? You hold X on the controller. That's it. Or was it Start? I don't remember. It was one of the two, but it was either X or Start on the controller, and that's it. And the game even has some special custom lines to reflect that you're playing co-op. Yeah, I know. It's not many, but it has some. And you play on equal footing as two equals in this co-op playthrough. It amazed me to no end when I saw it, and I was like, you know, this is the perfect game. It really, really is. I mean, it's just the perfect game. I can think of nothing wrong with this game. It's absolutely bloody amazing. And, yeah, it is, pretty much. I've been loving it, and those are the kind of games that I want to play, games that I genuinely enjoy, bearing in mind that I do want to provide a variety of genres as well here. I don't want to stick to just, you know, RPGs and stuff like that. We'll go to strategy games and other things too. There will be a bit of something for everyone, of course, but at the same time, I decided that I have a job right now, right? I'm financially relatively stable. We'll see how the job goes after this year, but if it all goes well for the duration of this year, then I have a job where I'm relatively stable. And I don't want to chase around anything on YouTube. I don't want to chase around anything on the internet. I'm here for a fun time. And I genuinely believe that this is where I produce, and this is the sort of mindset where I produce the highest quality videos. So I hope you join me for this ride. I hope you join me for the wonderful and amazing games that we're going to be playing throughout the year. It's not like I'm set in stone on what I want to play. I'm pretty sure I'm going to go through all three Witcher games, and I'm pretty sure I'm going to be regularly uploading one video, at least one video a day. So those are the biggest news as far as the channel goes. And other than that, today I would like to also reflect a little bit on the PC upgrade that I've made, tell you how that's going, and some future sort of plans around that, which don't really exist. I don't intend on upgrading anything, except maybe buying another storage device, like another NVMe drive, or maybe like an SSD or something, just for raw file storage, storing of like recorded videos, raw footage, etc., etc. Maybe buy a 500 or a terabyte SSD or something like that. It doesn't need to be ludicrously fast. I just need to hold on to physical files while I'm uploading and stuff. So maybe that. And I did also want to buy a TV at one point during this year, like a nice 4K TV, so I can play some games on that, RPGs and stuff, so I can go on the bed, get on the controller, and, you know, play like that. Speaking of controllers, I have a complaint or two about those, but we'll get onto the hardware section of the update, I guess, in a minute or two. For now, I wanted to conclude with this. Metro was another series that I really loved. I think I mentioned it, but yeah, I played through Metro Exodus, I think, for the channel, and that was amazing. It's one of my favorite series. A game that really stuck with me. And I still remember a lot of those missions. I still remember a lot of those conversations. And I get the feeling that I understand people that don't want to watch necessarily the third playthrough on YouTube of something, because it's, you know, ultimately it is the same quests and the same dialogues and stuff, but at the same time, it is my favorite thing to do, and it is where I do my best work, so what can I say? Anywho. That's the plan for the channel. Videos every day, and videos of stuff that I genuinely want to play. I'm not saying that I'm going to be completely oblivious and blind to all the new releases, mind you. Quite the opposite. I still want to do first impressions and stuff like that. The bread and butter of the channel when it comes to attracting new people, at least I like to think so. It makes a lot of sense for me to make videos like that. I think it's useful both for you guys, and I like doing them. But for longer term content, for longer Let's Plays, stuff that takes days, weeks to finish, months even, I don't want to do stuff that I don't like. I don't want to do stuff that I'm not enjoying, and I most of all don't want to start playing a game and then abandon it halfway through, because, well, part of the reason being, at least part of that reason being, I'm not having fun with it anymore. right? I really don't want to do that. I feel like it's unfair to you guys, and more so than that, I hate it. Personally, from the personal level, I hate it. I hate putting up partially completed Let's Plays on my channel. Unless it makes sense, you know, like with a Stellaris Let's Play, for example, when you get to a certain point where there's no point in just playing out towards the end date, right? You've achieved everything you wanted and set out to within that particular theme of the Let's Play, right? Think of Star Trek, the Star Trek overhaul. I've achieved everything I wanted in that. I've formed the United Federation of Planets, and now the Let's Play is over. We won. But in terms of, like, I have to bring out Starfield. I couldn't finish that game. If I started recording it, I wouldn't be able to finish it. It's just not interesting enough. For me, personally. Again, you're welcome to like it all you want. I'm not even saying it's a bad game. It's not for me. Probably the same with Elden Ring. I doubt I will be able to actually play through Elden Ring as a Let's Play. It's just not really for me. And at the same time, I'm able to recognize the genius behind its design and just how good the game is in terms of gameplay, story, lore, everything. I understand how good the game is. It's one of the, probably is going to be one of the best games of the decade. From 2010 to 2030, probably the last two decades, is going to be one of the highlight games out of all of them. Absolutely. I recognize this. I'm capable of recognizing it, but I'm also capable of recognizing that it's not really all that for me, that there are other games that I would much prefer to play. And that's kind of what I want to focus on for the channel as well. And I hope you join me on this journey and adventure, I suppose. But anyways, ladies and gentlemen, that has been it as far as the YouTube videos and series are concerned. So, we're wrapping up in the next month or so. We're wrapping up Project Zomboid. I'm going to continue playing and finish Bioshock Remastered, the first one. Whether I'll play 2 and 3 sort of depends on how I like 1 from start to finish. I might go and play 2 and 3, but for now, I really want to go back into like a more traditional RPG like The Witcher and stuff like that. I would really like to play that. Anywho. So, I would love to do that. And obviously the first impressions, stuff like that, goes in between, and I will finish, as soon as I fix OBS, I will finish Mass Effect 2, and probably leave Mass Effect 3 for a little bit later down the line in the year at some point, when usually I think it's around summertime that there's not a lot of releases, right? So I'll probably wait until summer and finish Mass Effect 3 around that time. Because there won't be a lot of new releases. Generally, the summer drought is a thing for video games. Alright, so, with that said, let's go over to some of the hardware stuff. First of all, how's the computer handling? Magnificently well. It's pretty much everything I ever wanted and dreamed of. Performance in video games in general has been phenomenal. I've been playing through Cyberpunk, I've almost finished it. It's been phenomenal, right? Cyberpunk's a great game now as well. They fixed most of the problems I had with it. Don't mind the crash at the beginning of the video. That was, again, that's OBS. But yeah, it's truly, shall we say, special. They've made it. They've took a dumpster fire of a game, and they made it work. With that said, though, computer works just fine. Nothing wrong with it. No problems whatsoever. The initial issues that I've had with AMD, with the drivers and stuff like that, have all been fixed. And other than OBS, everything's working just fine. And that's pretty much it. Like I mentioned previously, I kind of want to get a new TV and probably some storage device. But other than that, that's pretty much it. I'm well and truly happy. At one point, I will probably have to exchange this mouse. Although it still works fine, there's no issues with it, but until it does, until it fails, I'm not looking to change anything for my current setup. However, I do wish to sort of repeat what I said when I was initially looking to buy said PC, and that is that I still hold, to this day, the genuine belief that for a long while now, the PC market is going to be very much, well, the PC consumer base is going to be very much happy with computers like this. If you recently upgraded to, say, DDR5 and one of the latest in the series of cards, either from AMD or NVIDIA, the 4000 series or the 7900 series, I think you're going to be happy for a long while. I think most of the truly groundbreaking, revolutionary changes that we're going to see in the tech world are probably going to happen with mobile phones, with handheld platforms, stuff like the Steam Deck, you know, stuff like that. I don't think we're going to have anything too revolutionary when it comes to PC. And I think this, the current rigs like this one are going to last us indeed for a very, very long time. Hell, I mean, I think DDR4 is still going to last for a pretty long time, and, you know, even older systems, but especially systems like this, I think that whoever made the choice to upgrade is going to be very happy with his or her choice, and, well, I certainly know I am, so there you go. Anyways, with that said, ladies and gents, I would now like to just give me a second. There we go. Just doing something off camera. I would now like to share some potentially exciting news for those of you who are not here just for the video games, but are here for the pew pews. Oh yes, the pew pews. The occasional short video or something like that that I've posted. The occasional gun rant that I've posted. Yeah, for that. I have some exciting news for me personally, and well, for the channel also, because if everything goes well, I will be recording something related to this. Now, I don't want to jinx it, because the laws here for firearms are, like I said previously many times, not ideal, not very common sense, not very, well, not very liberal at all. It's just not very good. They don't make a lot of sense. But here's the thing. I've done all the paperwork, I've passed all the background checks, which just makes sense, of course you do. And I've done all the paperwork, I've gotten all the valid reasons to own a firearm, which I've ranted on about over time and time again. I've gotten all that, I've submitted it to the police, and hopefully, by the end of the month, let's say maybe beginning of February or so, I should have a particularly, particularly interesting firearm in my collection. I say I should, because there is one final thing I need to pass in order to actually get the permission or the permit to buy one, and that is that my neighbors have to agree with me owning a firearm. Yeah, and this is where the Americans laugh at the Europeans. I know, trust me, I know. Everything you're about to tell me, I know. But it's not as bad as I make it sound to be. The whole process involves a police officer coming to your house and then confirming that you have the proper conditions to store the firearm. So, a safe, keys that are tucked away, etc., etc. Is it unconstitutional in America? Probably, I don't know. But is it a bit ridiculous? Yeah, I get that also. Kind of like your business, what are you going to do with it, and etc., etc. But I also understand the other side, and doesn't matter, I don't really have a problem with it. If they want to come and check where I store my guns, fine. It's not like I'm looking to take up arms against the government or whatever and start an armed rebellion or something. I don't care if somewhere someone knows where I keep my gun and that someone is a police officer. I really don't. Like, yeah, fine. The problem is they then have to go around the neighborhood and ask people, do you mind if he has a gun? Except, thankfully, the questions aren't so direct. The questions are more along the lines of, have you ever been in conflict with him? Has he ever attacked you? Has he ever done damage to your personal property or something along those lines? And if they say no, then you're good. If they say yes, you get denied the permit, obviously. Is it up to them to prove that what they're saying is true? Not really. Which is a bit of a problem, which means basically that if you are in conflict with one of your neighbors, he can just straight up lie and deny you your permission to get a gun. However, it's not really all that simple, in the sense of a lot of people don't understand that there's no repercussions for them lying, thankfully. So a lot of people have this attitude that, oh, I probably shouldn't lie to the nice police officer, thankfully. So it's very rare that that causes a problem. Most people answer truthfully when asked. In fact, the vast majority of them do. So speaking of, I don't have any problems with any of my neighbours. Just to make that abundantly clear, right? I really don't. I've never been in conflict with any one of them. I've never argued with any one of them. I've been a model citizen and a model neighbour, right? I really have. So I'm not worried at all. I've got all my paperwork. I've done all the health checkups, the training. I have a valid hunting license until next year. I think that's how they issue them. So you get it renewed every year. Mine is valid until the end of 24, I think. Let me just check out it in my wallet. Yep, it's valid until December 24. So I should be able to acquire that particularly interesting for the channel piece of weaponry. And if I do, hoo boy. There is also a new shop that opened up in the capital city of Belgrade. And that shop specializes in importing really cool attachments for firearms. I'm thinking Magpul magazines, flashlights, vertical grips, scopes, red dots, magnifiers, etc., etc. And I will oh so definitely be paying them a visit. And, well, I don't want to spoil it and give it away what I want to buy and what I intend on buying, but let's just say that a lot of those guns from Stalker Anomaly that you've seen me wielding around, well, hopefully, before the end of the month, or around the end of the month, beginning of February, we'll be able to test them out for the channel and record them and shoot them for the channel within YouTube guidelines and all of that on a firing range and everything, you know, safe and legal and etc., etc. We'll be able to shoot them, you know, in real life by the beginning of February. So, obviously, I am beyond excited for that. It hopefully will happen. And yeah, that's pretty much it. So that's the other news that I have. PCs, like I said, covered everything regarding the PC. All is good. And I think that's it when it comes to this video. Thank you very much for watching, ladies and gentlemen. Like, subscribe down below if you enjoyed the video, and stay tuned with the rest of the content that I produce on this channel. And, well, there will be quite a bit of content, I promise you that. Let's plays galore, and hopefully some really, really good videos. Videos in which I will genuinely try to do my best, and I promise you a fun time if you do choose to stick along and tag along for these playthroughs and Let's Plays and stuff like that. Because I do have some really exciting plans for the future. And yeah, I hope you join me and see them through with me. Anyways, until next videos and until the next playthrough, until the next Let's Play, really, thank you for watching. Have fun, take care, and bye-bye.